Hi, you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation.
Woo!
Man, Holyfield, how you doing today?
I'm doing great.
Great to see you at the convention, man. Just talk about like the heavyweight division, man. The Anthony Joshua fight was last night. Did you get a chance to watch it all?
Well, I didn't get a chance to watch the fight. I heard about it. It was a good fight.
Yeah, man. In the heavyweight division, like, who are some of the guys you looking at?
DONTAE'S, and you know, so I guess it's time for them to try to wrap it up and get one champion.
It's a great event we got going on here. Who are you looking forward to like meeting up with the most?
Well, you know, I'm here to help the WBC. I think WBC is one of the better organizations that help the game of boxing. I think it's always important when people come together and something for the fighters to give them a better life, more so than just looking to receive it.
Speaking as like a former fighter yourself, a great fighter at that, what are some things you would like to see the boxing world, like WBC or commission like the WBC, do to help the fighters more?
Well, I think the WBC is doing a great job. I think all the organizations should come together and think about the fighters and what it takes. Start working with the amateur kids. If there's the amateur kids, how about to do it? How great the professional ranks gonna be? I think that all the organizations need to start giving back to the amateur programs and strengthen the amateur program. And I think that would bring more clarity into the professional rank.
Yeah. How do they go about that? Like, how would you go with like all the sanctioning bodies coming together? Like, how would that happen?
Well, everybody, I think, got to come into rules and regulations that not so much the fighter dictates how the rules are, how the rules are governed by the people, and saying all the fighters need to fight each other. Can't nobody duck each other, and I'm going to give away this title because I don't want to fight this guy and all that. I think it's kind of dilute the game.
Yeah. Sign the contract and be a warrior like you are, just prove it over and over again.
Excuse me?
Saying like sign the contract and prove yourself like you did. You moved up and fought the best.
Well, it's not so much like I follow the rules and regulations. I think everybody should follow the rules. I think the game is bigger than the fight. You know, that's the reason they get into the game. One rule about it that kind of rules everything, but I think it's great to have different organizations because it gives more fighters opportunity, but it all should come down to who the very best in that weight division. And so, and I think that that's the most important thing. People want to know who is the best.
If you had any message for like kids who are coming up boxing right now, what would you tell them?
Well, of course, listen for all direction. Listen for all direction, allow you to get down. I'm who I am, I'm a Hall of Famer now because I didn't quit. This takes everybody to make it, but you know what? Correct them, man. Keep striving.
Yeah. You have a son who's a really talented amateur fighter. How is that, Eliezer? How is he doing right now?
Well, he's doing well. He's coming out with an injured hand, but you know, other than that, just like everybody else, you have to work for it. There's no easy way to be the very best.
All right.
You know, y'all look at the whole program, talking about who the better man, but you know when they fight. Like, I think both of the guys got time to work on the other things to be the very best. And when that time comes, the best man wins.
Who's the best pound for pound right now? Which one is Evander Holyfield?
Well, you know, it's hard to say that. You know, so many fighters. It's kind of hard. I think it's kind of hard to be the pound for pound best boxer. If you fight 106, 112, if you go by weight, you know, I'm telling you, the guy that is pound for pound best fighter is the guy that, it's not about the weight, it's about, I'm the best guy, and I fought all the best people, and everybody who wanted to fight shows up.
You told me a while ago, about a year ago in the interview, that you thought Deontay Wilder was the best out of all the heavyweights. Now with Anthony Joshua's progression, you still feel the same way or what?
Well, what I'm saying is that everything is always changing, so somebody's working and maybe somebody's not. The heart of the game is when people fight each other, you know. Everybody have opinion. There's a lot of great people with good amateur status that coming in. But I always tell people, amateur is how you learn how to fight. The sharper amateur, when people fight amateur style, they hold their hands up and they go get it. Uh-huh. And so the people who remain a long term like that is one going to be the very best fighter. Because you have to fight for respect. So when people know that you can fight, then they respect you. Then you got to outbox them after they give you respect. So, you know, I think that right now, of course, what is his name now?
Wilder.
Yeah, Wilder. Wilder, too, he hold the title longer than anybody right now. After all the young people, he still has it. Mm-hmm. He hadn't lost it. And so we had to somebody beat him.
He the man?
He the man.
Anthony Joshua is going to fight Vladimir Klitschko April 29th. Your reaction to that?
Well, I think it'll be a good fight. And, you know, and when you look at, I look at how the Bible said, where's your strength at? And the job he used is his strength. Mm-hmm. So I think if he fight like that, he's going to win. But experience what is his name again?
Wilder?
Yeah. experience should be his strength. Uh-huh. But, you know, it should be, but because he's been fighting longer, but in general, but when you, it's all depending on your background. Uh-huh. You know, he started boxing at a late age. Uh-huh. And so the people who, they said, Vincent, I started boxing at 8 years old.
Yeah.
You know what? It's just natural. It was a natural thing. You know, the fighters who start at a young age and who take care of themselves. Uh-huh. Anthony Joshua look like he take care of himself. And this Parky boy look like he take care of himself. There's a lot of them 25 years old guys who take care of themselves and they love what they doing and that was success start by. You know, if you're older, only way you can step there, you took care of yourself.
Did you watch the Parker fight?
No, I didn't get a chance to see it. I came on, actually. I didn't even see it. Oh, I knew that he, I think the guy that he even fought, Andy
Ruiz,
I realized that he was fast. And I felt the only way Parker can win because he throw more punches than Andy. And so when people just tell me about it, they say, you know, it was a very close fight, and because the guy throw more punches, he got it about 1 point. But I truly believe that when they have fights like that, I don't think think it should be over for Andy. I think they should just put him with the next great guy. And see, I'm not, you know, you just can't lose one fight and just fall off.
Yeah.
You got to let that guy be the tester for everybody else who think they good.
Uh-huh.
And you find that you got to find the best out of the best.
Uh-huh. And this might surprise you, Evander, when you watch the fight, but they were actually both really reluctant in the fight. They didn't really let their hands go. It was a chess match, and everybody was surprised because they didn't really punch a whole lot. So, I mean, why do you think that is?
Well, I'm saying that's the reason why people lose. You're trying to make it a chess match when you got to go get it.
Uh-huh.
And especially when you're fighting in a place that's not your own.
Yeah.
But, you know, I was a fighter that I didn't trust nobody to be on my side, so I go out there and get it. You know, I'm not going to lose, and I'm not going to lose by I didn't do enough.
Uh-huh.
My whole thing was just trying to figure you out and take you out of that as quick as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what fighters are supposed to do.
Yeah.
You know, this is the reason why when you leave it up to anybody's decision, you know, you always have a lot of complaints.